Hello, wish me again. Uncle Goat here. I got something I want to tell y'all. Now, I done jumped down off my high horse. I was on my high horse a couple of days ago because, you know, they was all those women and people who support them women, and they was marching on Washington the day after the inauguration. Well, I saw some things that made me pretty darn mad. So I'm going to get out my red mad marker here, because let me tell you something. They was a bunch of full grown old men who know better, whose mamas and grandmamas raised them better. Because you talking bad, you talking trash about women, you think you've got the right to tell a woman what she can do with her body. The only woman you got the right to tell that is the woman half of yourself. That's right. Every one of y'all old white men are homos. My sixth grade teacher, Mr. Ronald Gibbons, taught me that every man, every boy in class was a homo. And we all freaked out. And you're probably freaking out because I'm calling you a homo. You're a homo sapien. And doggone it, so are the women, and they should be treated like this. Equal. M-W equal. Equal pay, equal everything. Now that don't mean that the women can get out there and their women lib and do more. And that don't mean that y'all men who have doggone dominated those women forever, you know, they finally got some rights, and they finally got a country, one country in this whole world, because they had freedom finally. You enjoy your freedom, they enjoy their freedom. And, you know, I told you you're a homo, now I'm going to tell you, you're every one of you half woman. Every darn one of you, you're homo sapiens, and you're half woman. You're half female. Now, my logic behind this is, you got these designer dogs out here. You got a German Shepherd right here. Ooh, that's an ugly dog. There's its ugly tail and there's its four legs. Uncle Goat is not a German Shepherd, dog. And you got this weenie dog here. Let me draw you weenie dog. And let's see, here's its legs. That goes on the other side. There's a weenie dog legs. There's his head. And there's his other legs. And there's its tail. Okay, you got this German Shepherd, and you got this weenie dog, and then you come up with a German weenie, also known as one of those frankfurters. Well, anyway, this German dog is a man, and this is a woman, so it's man is half woman. See, it's the puppies here, they're half weenie dog. They're these German frankfurter things. Anyway, so every one of y'all men out there, y'all are half woman because your mama was a woman. And your grandma was a woman. And her mama and her grandma, all the way back down to Eve, was a woman. And if you don't believe in women's and men's and Eve and Adam and everything, let's take this just a little bit deeper here. Now, I know if we get past Adam and Eve and get a little bit deeper here, we're getting over some of y'all's head. And some of y'all people, like in that White House up there, y'all going to drown if you get a little bit over your head with science. Well, the alternative facts are not the ones we're talking about tonight. We're talking about the God honest genetic truth. So, a woman has two X chromosomes. Okay? That's a female, a woman. Now, a man has an X chromosome and a Y chromosome. You know what? That don't mean that he's better. See, you got the man is an XY and a woman is an XX. So anyway, if a man and a woman has a baby and they get two X's, then that means it's a woman. And if they get an XY, then that means it's a man. Now, if it's XX and the Y is missing, part of the Y is missing here, that means it's a man. So y'all are half women, ever darn one of you. Now get off your high horse and give them the same rights you got, because do you want them telling you whether or not, whether doggone or not, you can have a vasectomy? Do you want them telling you whether or not that you can have an appendectomy or anything else? I mean, your body, your decision, your family's decision. This is freedom. Now, I'm with everybody else. And for any of y'all that thinks all these Democrats and all these liberals love abortions, there's not a human on the face of this earth that loves an abortion. Abortion is awful, it's evil, it's rotten, and anybody that can support that wholeheartedly, then, you know, I don't have no problem saying that I don't like it. But what I have a problem with is telling them what their business is. So all y'all people out there, you know, you want them to raise that baby, but you don't want to pay for that baby after it's raised. They don't want to pay for that baby. And, you know, something's got to be done. And I don't know what it is, but it's not up to you and it's not up to me, because God gave us free will. He gave that woman who chooses to do whatever with her body free will. Gave you free will, me free will, we all got free will. And if you will not like free will, then you're not liking God's plan. So, you know, and my personal view on abortion is, okay, here's a woman who chooses, and there's a lot of men out there that force their women to have abortion, so we're going to put one of these messed up chromosomes. They want that abortion. You know what? They don't pass on their genes, and I think that they're sort of like this right here. If they can stand to have an abortion, I think they're like Loco Beso. And Loco Beso, do they need to pass on their genes and have more Loco Besos? If they want to have an abortion, that's not my business. That's between them and their God. And if you believe in hell, or you believe in purgatory, or you believe in forgiveness, that is between them and their God, not them and the people who are stuck up there working whenever they get ready and making a ton of money to decide what that woman is to do with her body. Whether she can choose to have an IUD or birth control or the morning after pill. Now, a lot of you's talking about those late term abortions. Nobody, there's not a doctor out there that I've ever heard of that will do a late term abortion unless the mother's life is in danger. Nobody. I don't know of anybody. If they're out there, hey, say 6 months on, if they do it and the mother's life ain't in danger, you know, then maybe the doctor and the mother both could be charged with a crime. But, you know, them making a decision about their body, whether to have a baby, if they've chose to have that baby and they go up to almost full term and that baby, you know, is, you know, it's too much of a mess. But anyway, you're half woman. Imagine if you woke up in the morning and you're a woman. Or wait, imagine this. You woke up in the morning, you're 10 years old again, and your mama's there with you. How you think she's going to vote on this issue? How you think she's going to feel about this? You know, does she want somebody telling her what decision she makes about her health? And it just starts there. You know, you start with one thing. Maybe they decided, okay, well,
women can't have whatever else. It's personal. It's not your business. It's not my business. It's their business. That's what freedom's about. So if you want to live in a free society where you have your freedoms, give everybody else their freedoms, because you're half woman and you're a homo, a homo sapien. Some of you are homosexual. Some of you are heterosexuals. Some of you are metrosexuals and pansexuals and quantum sexuals and God knows what else. There's so many sexuals out there I have no idea about. Some of you are C-sexuals, like those monks up there in the mountains, celibate sexuals. But anyway, don't worry about other people's business. Give everybody the freedom that we're supposed to have. Don't impose your religion on them. Because if you impose Jesus on them, what if they end up ruling? What if somehow they end up and they've got more representatives up there and it's the big S word? What if they're pushing Satan prayer in the schools? What if they're pushing Muslim prayer in the schools? What if they're pressing the Buddhist prayer in the schools? You know, the United States was formed on religious freedom because we were under the rule of a king who told us doggone well that we was going to worship the way he said to worship. And if that's what you want to do, then move back to where you've got a king and let us people have our freedom of religion here. Freedom to worship Jesus or not worship Jesus. Or if they want to worship their Allah or their Buddha or whoever else, just keep it out of the government. The government's got no business. Make private schools. Make all the schools private. I don't care. Just quit forcing your beliefs on everybody else. Give them the same freedoms that you wanted when you was griping about those women marching for their rights. Maybe you should go march for your rights. Bye-bye now.